they name, they are the names of the places, they are definite, but still they use al. Yes. So the use of al as the definite article is more generalized in Arabic than to, or as compared to English. Okay. In Arabic we use, I mean in English we use the only for making from indefinite to definite. But in Arabic we are using al as a generic name or abstract name also. You say in Arabic al-qahwa, like coffee. For coffee we say al-qahwa. In English we do not say the coffee, right? In general use, I want to drink coffee, you do not say I want to drink the coffee. But in Arabic we say ana urid an ashrab al-qahwa. So there is no specific, if there is no specific coffee, you are talking about the same general coffee, but still you are saying al-qahwa. Yes, it's in the common name, generic names. Also, there are so many names of the countries as you are seeing here, like al-Maksik and al-Urdun, that they are preceded, you know, the preceding letters is al. But it does not mean that you are making them definite, because they are already definite. They are proper names of those places. So just have this concept of the al in Arabic, that is more generalized. Even some you know, names of the people, they also have al, like al-Husayn, al-Hasan, al-Husayn. All those names, they are using al. Now, we have a map over here, and I also would like all of you to be familiar with the map, because we are learning Arabic and we should know that what are those countries, at least these major countries, they are like 20-21 countries, so we should know that where are they located. What are the western part of the Arab world, what is the eastern part of the Arab world. And it is also very helpful to understand the dialects, the regional dialects. If you go to the western part of the Arab world, their dialects are different from the eastern part of the Arab world. Okay? So you have this map over here in the book, and you have the numbers over there. So from number one, you are talking about the western part, and that is Morocco. Number one is Morocco. And Morocco is very close to Spain, as you know that. Then we have number two, that is the south, and in the west is Mauritania. Okay, and we have their capital of the country's name also. So Rabat is the capital of Morocco, and we call in Arabic we call Morocco Al Maghrib. Okay, the name of Morocco is Al Maghrib, and Rabat is Rabat. Then Mauritania. So in this, the capital of Mauritania is Nouakchott. Nouakchott is the name of the capital of Mauritania. You know about this scholar in America, Sheikh Hamza Yusuf, when he, alhamdulillah, embraced Islam and he wanted to learn Arabic and all the alim courses, he went to this country, Mauritania, and he learned all his knowledge of deen from there and the ulama of Mauritania. So it's the western part of the Arab countries. Then we have Algeria, and the capital is Algiers. Then we have Tunisia, Tunis. Then number five, we have Libya, and Tripoli is the capital. Do you know the Arabic name of Tripoli? Trablus. Trablus. And then we have Egypt, and the capital is Cairo, and Arabic name is Qahira. By the way, Qahira also, they use Al in the beginning, Al-Qahira. Yes. Then we have number seven is Sudan, and the capital is Khartoum. And Sudan area-wise is a big country, as you can see in the map. Is right after Misr. So Misr and Sudan, both of them, they are neighbors. And the mother tongue of the Sudanese people also Arabic. When you have so many Sudanese brothers and sisters here in our Muslim communities and they speak Arabic. Yes. And then we have Somalia. Mogadishu is the capital of Somalia. And then we have Jordan, the capital of that Amman. Now, these are two names. Do not be confused. One is Amman and one is Oman. Yes. So, Amman is the capital of Jordan. Oman is a country. And the capital of Oman is Muscat. So, these are two different countries. Then number 10 is Israel and Palestine. Now, subhanAllah, we have these two names. Originally, it is Palestine, Palestine. So, the capital is Al-Quds, that is Jerusalem. And then we have number 11 is Lebanon.
Look at the size.
As you can see on the top. Now, we are reading all the eastern part of the Arab countries. So, this area is called Levantine. And when you have the Syrian dialect in your book, so you think that these are the countries, they use this Syrian or Levantine or Eastern Arabic dialect. So, these are Jordan and Palestine, Lebanon, and then Syria. So, Syria is a main country in that area. That's why it's called Syrian Arabic or Shami. That is number 12. And the capital is Damascus. Lebanon has Beirut. Then number 13 is Iraq. The capital is Baghdad. Number 14 is Kuwait. And that the capital is also Kuwait. 15, Saudi Arabia is Riyadh. 16 is Qatar. And the capital is Doha. Number 17 is Bahrain. And the capital is Manama. 18 is United Arab Emirates, and Abu Dhabi is the capital of all these states. Number 19 is Oman, and the capital is Muscat, and 20 is Yemen, and the capital is Sana'a. So, from number 9 all the way to 20, keep in mind those countries. Okay, so this is like eastern side of the Arab. Their dialect will be more or less very close to each other. And from 1 to 8, keep in mind the western countries of the Arab side, of the Arab world. These will be more African countries. So their dialect will be a little bit different. And let me tell you one big difference in the letter Alif. When this eastern side of the Arab people, they pronounce Alif, they pronounce like the letter A in the word father in English. When we say father, it is A, Alif, Fa, right? Father. But when this western side of the Arab, the African countries, Tunisia and Morocco, when they pronounce Alif, they pronounce like A, the letter A in the word bat. When you say bat, you are not saying bat, you say ba, you know? So, for example, this is the same word kitab. This eastern side, they will say kitab, father, kitab, straight, yes. The western side, they say kitab, kitab, right? So it will be A as in bat. So this is the, yes, the difference in the dialect.
Is there any major difference between the Syrian and the Yemen side or Bedouin? Because Bedouin usually use the Yemeni dialect, so is there any difference, major difference between those two, or they are almost overlapping?
Okay, they have explained about that, but most of the structures are the same. There will be slight difference in their dialects. Bedouin's Arabic is more pure Arabic. Always remember the Bedouin Arabic, and it's not from this time. It has always been very pure Arabic.
Is it close to classical Arabic?
Yes, it is still close to classical Arabic, that's right. Because Bedouin people, they live in the desert, so they preserved the language. And this was the reason that even at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Arab people, they used to send their kids, their babies, newborn babies, to the Bedouin people are to the desert area for two reasons. One reason for the fresh and healthy air, and the second reason was the language. So that when these babies, they start, you know, speaking, they should, from the beginning, they should have the pure Arabic. So, Bedouin always, they have the pure Arabic. Okay. Now, go on page number 14, and we have the practice of vocabulary and conversation today. And today, inshallah, you will learn how you greet each other in Arabic and how do you introduce yourself in Arabic. So, inshallah, in few minutes, you are going to learn, yes, your introduction in Arabic. Okay. And what I will do, inshallah, I will make your groups. Now we are doing a group activity. So, two people, two brothers and two sisters, you make a group and you will practice, inshallah, how to introduce yourself in Arabic. Okay? So, you are six, mashallah, you can make three groups over there. And then you make a group of two people and you will start practicing. Now, what to practice, let's go and learn over there. The first thing, Assalamu alaikum, you know it. Then, how to say hello in Arabic? Ahlan.
Ahlan.
Ahlan. Okay. If it is difficult at this moment, this is the group activity that you will keep saying until this word will be very much familiar on your tongue. Okay. Now, on this page there is no response of Ahlan. It's just say Ahlan. Okay. But now I'm writing the response of Ahlan, because one of you say Ahlan, the second person will respond to that greeting. So that response will be Ahlan Beek for male. A male to a male or a female to a male will say Ahlan Beek in the response. When you will respond to either female, as a female you will say Ahlan Beeki. Beeki. So your, for male is Beek and for female is Beeki. Okay. I'm going to write it also. So, the very first word in our conversation is Assalamu alaikum, and then the second one is Ahlan. Ahlan, like this in English, and the response is Ahlan B. It will be for male. And for female, you will add I in the and B key. That's it. Okay?
What is B mean?
To you. Hello to you as well. Like that.
For now.
And the third thing that you will learn after. Now, Ahlan and Ahlan wa sahlan is same thing. Either you say Ahlan or you say Ahlan wa sahlan. So it's the same thing. Another way of saying hello is marhaba. And now you see here in the book, what is the difference? Is the just the difference of the regions. So in some Arab regions, they say hello. So in Egypt, they say ahlan. And in the Syrian countries, the eastern part of the Arab, they say marhaba. In Levant. So Levantine is marhaba. And Egyptian is Ahlan. But it's the same thing. You can, maybe some of you choose saying Ahlan, some of you choose saying Marhaba. Now, the response of Marhaba will be same as Beek and Beeki. Okay. So in the response you say Marhaban Beek,
Marhaban Beek.
And for female Marhaban Beeki.
But in a normal conversation, when the brothers are talking here, and I keep hearing, they skip that part. They say the same way.
Is also another use. It's not full use of that. Sometimes they make it short. But as a learner, we should learn.
This is more formal. Actually.
More formal also, yes, and more complete, yes.
Can you write this in Arabic?
Ah, yes.
Mahadan.
Okay, it will be the same. B. If for the male, they will stop on calf, there is a beak. And for female, just you put the kasra, so it will beak. That's it. Okay. Now, the second part of your conversation will be introducing yourself. You say, my name is, right? So in Arabic, you say, Ana Ismi. Ana Ismi. And it's written here in both English and Arabic, so you can read in the book. Okay, after Ana Ismi, everyone will add his or her name. Right? If brother Harun will introduce, he say, Ana Ismi Harun.
Yeah.
Myself will introduce, Ana Ismi Zafar. So you will add your names after Ana Ismi. So that will be our third part, my name. Yes. Ana Ismi. And then such and such. After that, you wanna say that this is my name and I'm from the city. So you will say in Arabic, min Madinat. Min Madinat is from the city of. Now you will mention the name of your city. For Frisco example, min Madinat Frisco. Plano, min Madinat Plano. Because there is no P sound, so you will say with B. It will become like that, Plano. This is Arabic Plano. If someone is Richardson, you right now you can say Richardson, but later on you will learn how to say
Richardson.
Richardson. But it's right now it's okay if you say Richardson, no problem. Okay? If someone is a Garland, say Garland or Jarland. Or Irving, so it will be Erfinge. Erfinge, yes. Or Irving is okay. But do not hesitate to say the name of the city and do not think that what should I say in Arabic. Just say English at this point. Then, Ana Ismi Min Madinat, this is my name, I am from this city. And the last will be same for everyone because you are telling the name of the state. Fi Texas. Yes. The Texas in Arabic will be Texas.
That is state, right?
Your
city.
Yeah, this is the state. So after city, you will say. First you say min Madinat from the city. Yeah. Then you say fi Texas.
And it should be C or B, depending on which.
Yes. The Syrian people, they say B Texas. So fi and B, they deliver the same meaning of in. B.
Is it common that? Yeah. Is it common that if you speak one or the other in a different region, will be understood?
Yes. Most of this is not a big deal. Like this one, fee or B. It will be understood everywhere. Equally. Okay. Now start practicing. Yes.
Just going back to some conversation with someone. He asked,
Ishmael.
The person replied, Ismi Javed.
Uh-huh.
He didn't say, Ana Ismi.
Okay.
So, that's right.
Yes.
I asked that person, when you say Ismi, it automatically by default has
Abu. Yes.
Abi.
Abu.
Yes.
That is the ya in the end, it's a possessive. It's the possession. So itself it is giving you the meaning my. But when you say Ana Ismi, this is also another way. And especially in the beginning of the conversation, you start with that. So if without Ana also, your sentence will be complete. If you just say Ana.